Well, Stallions and Stallionettes, tomorrow Resident Evil Village is finally dropping after building a ton of anticipation. Technically tonight, if you want to ignore your wife and kids and pull an all-nighter, nothing wrong with it. I've been doing it for years and it's worked out all right for myself. But are you going to get your money's worth out of this game, as it is a $70 title if you're getting it on the new-gen consoles like the PlayStation or the Xbox Series? And what is there to do in-game after you've beaten the main story or campaign? Is there going to be a multiplayer? Is there any kind of side modes or any incentive to replay through the story? Let's get it. All right, you guys, share my screen. I have an article pulled up here. This will be cited or sourced down there in the description below, as I do anytime I cover any kind of news in the gaming community or industry. So I'm going to go ahead and stimulate your ear holes with my voice while I stimulate your corneas with some visuals of this game. Let's get it. After months of anticipation, Resident Evil Village is finally poised to be released tomorrow, and you'll be getting released tonight if you're willing to stay up late enough to play the game once it unlocks on your console or PC. As the eighth mainline entry in the long John-running survival horror franchise, it stands to reason that many fans who have been in the series grabbing ass and stacking cash since its inception will want to get through the story as quickly as possible, or else risk being spoiled by the game's events as they begin to naturally appear online by punk beezy spoilers. And to that end, if you're someone who's wondering how much penetration the game can handle before reaching its climax, according to our own reviewer, Tanner the Tan Man Deadman, it took him roughly 11 hours of hard thrusting until Resident Evil was left sweaty and fulfilled. This time is obviously one that might not ring true for every gamer, that might play like an absolute stallion or a Clydesdale pony. But it seems as though you can expect the storyline to reach the double digits at the very least. If you're someone who really likes to take it slowly, then flip it around and take it to Pound Town, perhaps on a higher difficulty, then the length could be much longer for you ladies. All in all, this time is pretty well in line with other games in the Resident Evil series. Resident Evil 7, which is the most recent entry in the franchise prior to Village, took around 9 to 10 hours to leave slain in the main vein for most players. The original Resident Evil lasted about the same length in time, while games like Resident Evil 4 and Resident Evil 6 do take a bit longer as they have been exercising and have more stamina. This series as a whole is one that actually doesn't take too much time to play. That being said, Resident Evil Village does offer things that will take your time up outside of the main campaign. Village actually sees the return of mercenaries, which is a popular mode that has appeared through other installments in the series. And although it's not launching with the game right away, the multiplayer experience Reverse is also poised to arrive later this summer. So even if you beat the game in a single weekend, or sitting, you fat lazy bastard, there's still a lot more to grab out your thick meat shovel and dig into. Resident Evil Village will release tomorrow, May 7th, and be coming hard and coming fast to PlayStation 4, PlayStation 5, Xbox One, Xbox Series S and X, and PC platforms. Good stuff, good stuff. So a lot of people are super hyped about this game. Will I be picking it up? Absolutely, probably not. To be 110% honest, the last Resident Evil game that I played start to finish was on the PlayStation 1. I played Resident Evil 1, 2, and 3 Nemesis. I did play a bunch of the Resident Evil demos on PlayStation 4, but it really didn't stimulate me, as I do appreciate survival horror games, but I haven't really been frightened or terrified from a Resident Evil game in a long time. I know the stories are good. I know they have a huge cult following. I probably just lost half my subscriber base by saying that I am personally not too excited for this game. However, I will caveat that by letting you guys know if I do have enough requests for me to review this game, do a comprehensive review, I will open up my fanny pack and drop in my 2 cents, my buffalo nickels, my shekels, my Da Vinci Code ducats, or whatever currency I have on me at that time. Damn, this camera and lighting. Oh my God, angelic. Okay, maybe not when you do that. Can you back up? You can see every pore in my face. There we go. Back off. But I think the main reason that I'm not super excited about this game is it looks like the scope or scale is substantially smaller than other Resident Evil games. What do I mean by that? Well, you're in a village, hence it's called Village. So it's a pretty small environment that you're in. It's not a wide open sandbox. It's not an open world or anything like that. So that's a little disappointing. Two, I watched a lot of gameplay footage, a lot of early release demo people streaming. I watched Alana Pierce's playthrough and a couple of others, and it just didn't look that appealing to me. It didn't look very exciting. So if something's not going to excite me, I'm not going to waste my time with it. However, like I said, I'm here to satisfy you guys. So if enough people want me to cover this game, I will, and I'll give my honest review. If it's good, it's a dank banger, as the kids say, it's hot, sticky fire, then I'll say that. if it has issues, as I'm sure it probably will, no game is perfect, and I'm sure this has some issues that need to be critiqued, I will also bring that to your guys' attention. The facts are the game comes out tomorrow, and a lot of people are really excited about this game, and it probably will be a very good game. So drop in the comment section below if you guys are going to be picking up this game. We'll get a little conversation going. If you enjoyed the video, liking it helps it to get seen by more people, so we can grow this channel from a limp doozer to a big, thick, veiny, girthy rager, which is what we're going for on this channel. Subscribe for more content like this. I cover a lot of news in the gaming community and industry, as well as tutorials helping you get set up, streaming and YouTubing, and I'll see you guys in the village, or most likely in the next video. Peace.